Thank you very much. Now let's go for the answer. Let us discuss the options one by one. First, print this can't happen. Cool. It's going to go to the console, probably going to go to some log, but it's unlikely that anyone will ever notice this. And this means that our traffic light, well, in our simulation, will be in some undefined state, possibly meaning that the traffic will also be in some undefined state. What happens if you have multiple traffic lights and one of them is neither red nor yellow nor green? Oh, this is going to cause lots and lots of interesting issues. So simply printing this out to the console is not enough. This problem is too hard. We are violating a data invariant here, which also rules out the last option. This is not a good option. Now for the two remaining choices, and this is a tough choice. We could have the assertion in here, assert false, which would be nice. But keep in mind that this could actually also be turned off, for instance, when invoking the Python interpreter with minus O. However, in this particular situation, there's no reason to turn this assertion off because, well, if it gets executed, then it raises an exception immediately. And if it does not get executed, then everything is fine, meaning that by turning it off, we don't get any savings. So the better option is simply to raise an assertion exception plain and simple and thereby to document that something is going really wrong in the program. This will not hurt performance at all, obviously, because it will only be triggered when all other checks already have failed. However, if this were a production program, you may wish to come up with some global try-catch block in the program, or in Python this would be a global try-except block that would catch all assertion exceptions and then pop up a dialogue saying, oh, we encountered a fatal error, possibly offering some recovery mechanism or some ability to save the progress that we've seen so far, such that the user is not confronted simply with all of his work disappearing.